On that, we are cutting across to Ahmedabad once again, where Prime Minister Modi is meeting with members of the Gujarat unit of the Bharatiya Janata Party. A number of members there have gathered to felicitate and welcome the victorious Prime Minister-elect to his home state of Gujarat. Remember, this election victory has as much to do with the duo of Mr. Modi and Amit Shah, but also very much so on the structure of the BJP, its organizational skills, and really speaking, the party cadre on the foundation of which the government, or rather the party, has come to power once again. Let me take that particular point across to WION's political editor, Karthikeya Sharma, who continues to be with us on the phone line. The architect, in many ways, Mr. Amit Shah, Karthikeya, that is what the overall assessment is. But this victory has everything to do with the party's phenomenal organizational skills.
I think a phenomenal organization. More than that, it's the urgency which the organization shows at the time of we have things. You know, every political party has a body of organization, but the sort of booth level organization which Bharatiya Janata Party has, and you know, Prime Minister made it a point to mention it when he was there at the Bharatiya Janata Party's headquarters, when he spoke about Panna Pramukh, that people would dismiss them, but the Panna Pramukhs have shown how things can be radically changed at the booth level. It's something which other parties need to learn. It is a system whereby you ensure that everyone who is associated with BJP comes out and vote. That is why even the tagline for BJP's campaign was "Sabse mazboot apna booth." So you know, the booth is the focal point for any political action during a polling day. And right. I think BJP understands it very well, Aisha.
Absolutely. Stay with me, Karthikeya. Let's up the sound on those visuals so that our viewers can get an idea of the sort of euphoria that is underway in Gujarat among the number of people who have gathered there to see Mr. Narendra Modi and to hear him in his first speech in the state of Gujarat following his electoral victory earlier this week.
भारत माता के वंदे एक ऐतिहासिक विश्वास जीत्या पछी पोतानु गुजरात आपनु गुजरात सौना नरेंद्र भाई मोदी
Right, so the warm-up speeches beginning in many ways, leading up to the star attraction. If this were a concert, Karthikeya, the main billing or the main drawing, of course, has to be Prime Minister Modi. We'll, of course, cut into that speech as and when it begins. For now, let's just talk a little bit more about the importance, as we were talking about a little while earlier, about the BJP's approach to elections, the machinery that never seems to stop. It's a well-oiled machine that's become very apparent in the last 5 years, be it state elections and now, of course, the general election. Is it safe to say that under the charge of Mr. Modi and, of course, Amit Shah, it really doesn't take a break, that it's always, in many ways, in election mode?
Ideological clarity, you know, you agree with it, you disagree with it. Today, you know, where does BJP stand when it comes to economic issues? Where does BJP stand when it comes to ideological issues? You know, where does BJP stand when it comes to religious, cultural issues? We know the position of BJP on cows. We know the position of BJP on beef. We know the position of Bharatiya Janata Party on cultural nationalism. We know their position on certain issues, that they will have a conservative position, like, for example, they had an LGBT. We know what position they want to take on Sabrimala and Ayodhya. But can we say that for sure for the Congress party? Apart from few issues, what issues they'll take? So, you know, the organization functions around an ideological core. So that ideological core is not clear. You know, for example, the Congress party, failed to communicate that to an extent. Like in our earlier conversation, I spoke about the national security really decimated Congress Party. Now, a lot of people said, you know, it was ASPA was a wonderful issue to be discussed in the manifesto. But, you know, Aisha, what were the critics saying? Mm-hmm. That the BJP demolished Congress Party on the issue of ASPA because they said we will dilute three norms. What were the three norms? Sexual harassment, another was judicial killing, and there was one more. So, on paper, intellectually, theoretically, it was all right, you know. These things cannot be accepted when ASPA is implemented. You know, you can't rape a person, you can't have a judicial killing. But in elections, it was not the detail which was being discussed. It was a discussion point saying that this Congress wants to weaken our security forces, and ASPA is a case in example where they want to dilute the cover. And, you know, Congress just couldn't explain. And this NGO-ish, the sort of approach towards manifesto making became very, very apparent. So even in this case, Aisha, which I was just discussing with you, that what is the core of Congress Party today? Where does it stand? That needs to create a clarity. You know, yesterday, Rahul Gandhi was pointing fingers at Ashok Gehlot that you sat in Delhi for 7 days for your son to get ticket, or Chidambaram, that, you know, he was threatening me to resign if I don't give a ticket to Karthik Chidambaram. But what an irony that for the first time in history, a working committee of the Congress Party had three Gandhis together. You had Sonia Gandhi, you had Priyanka Gandhi, and you had Rahul Gandhi. So how do they expect people to listen to them? So similarly, it is all boiling down to that ideological core. BJP's ideological core is pretty clear. You know where they stand. You know whether you agree with them or you do not agree with them, but you exactly know what the response is going to be. And I think that has fetched in this victory. Like, for example, in 1971, people knew exactly what Indira Gandhi would be doing.
But tell me, Karthikeya, I mean, how much of the current, clarity when it comes to the BJP's ideology has to do with the man leading the party? And I'm not talking about Amit Shah, I'm talking very specifically about Prime Minister Modi. A lot of people said that this election was presidential in some forms because the vote really boiled down to whether you're voting for Mr. Modi or against him. That sort of divide was very clear amongst the electorate. Do you think that that is something that's going to continue in the future of the party, whether or not Mr. Modi is at the helm of it?
Absolutely. It's a very good question, Aisha. I spoke to a couple of friends in RSS and I asked them, what did you like about Modi's speech? They asked me, those who were in RSS, that what did you like, Karthik, about Modi's speech? I said, what I liked about Modi's speech was that he said that the Constitution will not be tinkered with. The answer I received from those who were part and part of RSS were, they said, what we liked about the speech was that Modi did not use the word pseudo-secularism. He used the word secularism. I said, I didn't get it. They said Advani had coined the word pseudo-secularism, that our version of secularism is correct, and Congress version of secularism is that, which is pseudo-secularism. But what did Prime Minister say? That the word secular was being used to attack us. He didn't even use the word pseudo-secularism. So somehow, he's gone back to the core position of the RSS, that the word secularism is not required. We are anyway a plural society, but then the core of that society belongs to Hindus. So, you know, one has to decide what one takes from one's speech. What Prime Minister has done, despite saying that his commitment towards minorities and saying that we have to ensure that the smaller segments within the country will be taken care of. But the message is very clear. Undivided Hindu vote remains the core of Bharatiya Janata Party.
Right.
I'm not saying it means that, under BJP's dispensation, there will be a problem for minorities. No, absolutely not. Because, you know, constitutional provision kicks in. You know, we have a constitution. But the undivided Hindu vote will remain the ultimate commitment. And it is for this reason, you see, throughout the campaign, 370, the issue of 35A, BJP never diluted its stand. Because what did Prime Minister say from BJP headquarters? Hum do the, but even then we did not compromise on our ideology. I think this is a rude call for the Congress Party because, you know, they never went down to two seats,
right.
Though they are in double digits. But the ideology on which they want to fight election is so ill-defined, is so amoebic. It's so formless that it amazes me as a journalist.
Fair enough. Stay with me, Karthikeya. You know, we're waiting for the Prime Minister to begin his address there in Ahmedabad. He is on stage with the BJP's party president, Amit Shah, as well as the Chief Minister of the state, that is Vijay Rupani. They're all there in Gujarat, in Ahmedabad, where the Prime Minister has arrived for his first visit to his home state following the electoral victory this past Thursday. Now, there are a number of speeches that are going to take place.